A couple of final takeaways from the day that I highlights that I think are worth restating one more time, at least what I was hearing over the day. On the vaccination priority and distribution questions, the first panel, it's important for us to be clear on the goal. Is the goal of the vaccination program to prevent infectious disease or prevent fatalities? And if so, then we need to orient the program around that goal. Going forward, it would be ideal if we could try and match the vaccine high priority groups to the amount of vaccine that's available at the time, if that's feasible. Priority groups should evolve as we learn more about who's at risk. They're going to be dynamic over time. The vaccine formulations that we have should match the priority groups to the extent that's feasible. If pregnant women are a priority, then we need to have vaccine that we can give to pregnant women. The vaccine distribution system should take advantage of all the routine distribution systems that we have. On hospitals, the 2009 pandemic didn't really test the healthcare system's ability to respond in the way that we would have to in a catastrophic event, but we learned some key areas of vulnerability. ED surge capacity, emergency room surge capacity is a key vulnerability, ICU capacity is a key vulnerability, and the coordination of medical and public health response in the response to a catastrophe is key. And we need a better system for assessing the sickest patients. We need to learn more about what's happening inside the hospitals at the beginning of an epidemic. On disease containment, we should anticipate political pressure to take strong action in the setting of a lot of uncertainty. And we need to understand that the policies that we may have in place are potentially have adverse consequence and may or may not be feasible in the practical real world. Nikki said we need new strategies to speed up countermeasure and vaccine production, and I think we all agree. Media is not your friend, but it's critically important and embrace it. Public communication is extraordinarily important, but the language is important and we're still looking to try and improve that. And medical and public health emergency response requires our support, both financial and moral. Let me commend to you in a shameless plug a report that the center just completed, which is on the table on the way out, which deals with a subset of these issues called the Next Challenge in Healthcare Preparedness, Catastrophic Health Events. It's a serious analysis of some of these issues. You can read it on the way home. And more importantly, let me thank again our funder for the program, the Sloan Foundation and Paula. Thank you to all the speakers and panelists. Special thank you to my colleagues at the Center for Biosecurity who were extraordinary in setting this conference up. And thank all of you for staying and listening. And please join us in a reception upstairs on the top floor. We'll have treats and beverages, and hopefully we can continue this conversation for a bit longer. Until next time, thanks so much.